I was reading the last few chapters of The Never-Ending Sacrifice.
Isn't it superb? Without a doubt, the finest Cardassian novel ever written.
I'll take your word for it.
So you didn't enjoy it?
Well, I thought it was interesting. Maybe a little dull, in parts.
Oh.
I can't believe that I'm having lunch with a man who thinks The Never-Ending Sacrifice is dull.
I just thought the story got a little redundant after a while. I mean, the author's supposed to be chronicling seven generations of a single family, but he tells the same story over and over again. All of his characters lead selfless lives of duty to the state, grow old, and die. Then the next generation comes along and does it all over again.
But that's exactly the point, Doctor. The repetitive epic is the most elegant form in Cardassian literature, and the never-ending sacrifice is its greatest achievement.
None of his characters ever really come alive. And there's more to life than duty to the state.
A Federation viewpoint, if ever I heard one. An adaptation of one of Shoggoth's Enigma tales.
The trouble with Cardassian Enigma tales is that they all end the same way. All the suspects are always guilty.
Yes, but the challenge is determining exactly who is guilty of what.
What is it?
Meditations on a Crimson Shadow by Prelock.
More Cardassian literature.
I think you'll find this one more to your taste. It takes place in the future, during a time when Cardassia and the Klingon Empire are at war.
Who wins?
Who do you think?